Welcome to Divine Yoga LA. My name is David Ibrahim, and I'm your yoga instructor today. Thank you for joining us. I have Sophia on my right side and Leah on my left. And we're gonna do some healthy yoga today. Make sure you've checked in with your doctor to find out if these are poses that are good for you. We're gonna do a standing session for about 20 minutes, and then we're gonna end in laying down in Shavasana. These are gonna be hip openers, releasing the muscles in the hips and the legs, and working our entire lower torso and our upper torso as well. Before we begin, I just want to touch on our ujjayi breathing, the victory breath, allowing yourself to go gently with the breath. It's very important to breathe during our yoga poses. The oxygen will fuel your muscles and it'll help you stay mindful, allowing your mind to stay in touch with your breathing. It's a very powerful way of enhancing your experience in yoga. And it's what makes it unique from all the other physical arts or exercises. So why don't we begin? We're going to bring our palms towards our heart. And we're going to allow ourselves to gently close our eyes if you like, or keeping them in a soft gaze, allowing yourself to come away from the world outside and to come to this peaceful world of yoga. Let's look within. We're going to take a deep inhale, exhaling, inhaling again, exhaling, using that internal breathing to release all of our muscles. We're going to inhale again. Exhale, releasing your neck and your jaw. Inhaling again. Exhaling, and remember to warm up before doing these exercises. You can look to our first video, the warm-up series, Pavan Muktanasana was the joint freeing series. Let's continue to inhale. We're gonna exhale. Releasing any tension in the legs, in the calves, and in the ankles. Inhaling, lengthening your breathing. Exhale, slowing down that exhale. This kind of breathing has been scientifically proven to switch us from the stress response to the relaxation response. So you can breathe like this throughout the day, periodically allowing yourself to fill up your belly with air on an inhale. Abdominal breathing, exhaling, releasing the belly, inhaling again. We're going to exhale. We're going to bring our two feet together, and we're going to gently interlace our fingers on an inhale, letting them float up towards the ceiling. If you have high blood pressure, you can bring your hands towards your sides. You will stay where you are. That's great. And you can do these poses with your hands by your side, or if it feels okay, finding where is a balance that feels good for you. Maybe you can come midway. You can also bring your hands to your shoulders if this feels good. Depending on your range of motion, you could just do your elbows if that feels right. And we're going to inhale, gently letting ourselves pull out from our waist, extending our arms up towards the ceiling in a soft lift. And we're going to come up onto our toe hinge. So we're coming onto our tiptoes. Exhaling down, gently lifting our toes off the mat. This is great for balance. Depending on our ages or the experience we have in life or our own stability and strength in our ankles, this is a nice way to bring us into balance. Inhaling up, exhaling down, inhaling up, exhaling down, and lifting the toes up and then bringing them back onto the mat. We're gonna exhale, stretching out towards one side. And we're going to inhale back to center, exhaling towards the opposite side. Inhaling back to center, exhaling towards the opposite side. Remembering to breathe through our nostrils today, we're going to flow from one side to the other. This is called palm tree vinyasa, tadasana vinyasa. We're going to let ourselves flow like a beautiful palm tree in a sweet spring breeze. Inhaling and exhaling, and letting yourself extend out from your hips. We're going to do one last side. and coming back to center, inhaling here. And then we're going to slowly exhale towards the other side, letting ourselves stretch our hips, stretching out from our hips. We're going to come to center. If you like, you can bring your hands by your side for a moment just to release the shoulders. Just taking a nice moment, we're going to inhale, rotating our arms back, warming up all of our joints. Your range of motion today is not what matters, it's that you are moving if you can move. If you're bedridden and you cannot move, allow yourself to visualize the movements. This helps the muscles start tuning in to eventual movement. And slowly returning back to center, we're going to inhale our palms up again and keeping them here for a moment. If it feels better to bring your hands to your elbows, you can do that. Finding what feels right for you today. Everybody's shoulders are a little different. I like to keep mine up. We're going to inhale and turn towards our right side. Exhale back to center, feeling that beautiful flow of life. Inhaling towards the other side. You can tighten your thighs a little bit, or your gluteus maximus, your buttocks. Inhaling towards one side, giving a nice gentle tight and release to center. Then you can tighten them again and inhale, turning towards the opposite direction, releasing back to center. We're going to do that. We're going to do it two more times. You can start at 3 breaths and work up to 6 breaths. So for each breath is another movement. We're going to do one more side. And coming back to neutral. Again, we could bring our arms by our side and gently giving a soft massage, turning them back. Then going forward, exhaling, remembering to breathe. And coming back to center. We're going to bring our arms out. We're going to face our palms up towards the ceiling. We're going to inhale, turning towards one side. Exhaling back. And inhaling towards the opposite side. Exhaling back. Keeping our thighs together. If that feels good, if not, you can just do the turn. And coming back to center. This is great for the spine, giving flexibility to the spine. And coming back to center, I'm going to bring our arms down by our side again. And just breathe here in mountain pose, Tadasana. Everybody's hips are a little different. If it feels better to open your feet out, you can open your feet a few inches apart, finding what feels right for you. You can explore today what feels good for your body type. No two bodies are alike. No two people are alike. Finding what feels comfortable for your body. I like to keep my feet together. I'm going to inhale here. We're going to exhale, bringing our palms up by our heart again in Shanti Mudra, the seal of peace. Inhaling, feeling that beautiful breath of life fill you up. You can close your eyes and internalize the process, feeling your inner organs, your inner muscles, feeling that breath of life on an inhale trickle through you. Inhaling, filling up your stomach, exhaling. And we're going to turn towards this side of the mat. We're going to inhale, we're going to exhale, opening our feet 2 to 3 feet apart. And we're going to inhale and gently rotate to face the top of your mat, the front of your mat. We're going to bend our front knee. We're going to come into Warrior One. We're going to inhale. You can either interlace your fingers over your head if this feels good, or you can open them out a few inches if that feels better. You can even close them, finding what feels right for you today. You can bring them to your hips if you have high blood pressure or any kind of shoulder issues or neck issues. And we're going to inhale here. We're going to exhale and gently roll over. You can come halfway if this feels better for your lower back. If you have a tight lower back, you don't want to go all the way down. The girls are flexible, so they can come all the way down. And then releasing our head down towards the floor if that feels good. Or looking a few inches in front of you if you have high blood pressure. Finding what feels right for you today. We're going to inhale and come back. And we're going to come into Warrior Two. Whenever our knee is bent like this, we want to make sure our knee is lined up with our heel. So I'm going to turn sideways. And you girls just keep on breathing. You folks out there can breathe also, continue to breathe. We don't want to push our knee over our heel. We want to line it right up. Over time, if we keep doing that, it'll create problems in the knee area. And it's okay to come a little back if that feels better. Finding what feels right for your knee. We're going to continue breathing. Remember, your body needs the oxygen. And we're going to come into warrior two. For those who have limited mobility, you could come into half of a warrior, not going too deep. Finding what feels right for your body type. We're going to inhale here. Lining our arms straight out from our shoulders. Exhaling. We're going to inhale and we're going to come down to the floor, bringing your hand right by the side of your foot. If you have high blood pressure, again, you can just come halfway. And what we're going to do is we're going to exhale our arm up towards the ceiling. And we're going to look at that extended arm pointing up if this feels good. You can always adjust. No need to do the full pose if you can't do it. You want to find where you are today. We're going to inhale, coming back into warrior two, Virabhadrasana. We're going to exhale, coming into reverse warrior, bringing one arm towards our back calf, our other arm up towards the ceiling. Inhaling here. We're going to exhale back into warrior two. And we're going to bend our front elbow and bring it right into the top of our thigh, exhaling our arm up and over. You can look up towards the ceiling if that feels good. If you have any neck issues, you can look down. Learning to listen to your body. And you can inhale and come back into warrior two. Exhale back into reverse warrior, giving a nice extension to the side of the hips. Inhale here and coming back. That's great. Exhaling. Inhaling again, we're going to bring our hands to the side. And when we're in warrior two, we want to make sure our hips are facing the side of our mat. We're going to bring we're going to bring our palms together. That's great. We're going to exhale, bring our front elbow right inside our front bent knee. And we're going to look up towards the ceiling. Inhaling here, making sure you're still breathing. Exhaling, coming back into warrior two. Very easy to stop breathing. We're going to inhale again into reverse warrior. Exhale back into warrior two. And we're going to straighten our front leg out. We're going to come into Trikonasana, triangle pose. And we're going to inhale. You could come halfway if you don't have extended mobility. If you're flexible, you can come all the way down, finding what feels right for you. We're going to bring our opposite arm up towards the ceiling. And we're going to look at our thumb. We're finding a nice visual point. Breathing here. We're going to bend our front knee. We're going to exhale back, coming into warrior two again. Inhaling here. Exhaling. Inhaling. Exhaling. We're going to push our back foot to meet with our front, coming into Shanti Mudra, seal of peace. Inhaling love, nourishment into our hearts today, taking this time to become spiritual warriors, practicing nonviolence in thought, nonviolence in words and in actions, allowing ourselves to cultivate self-love. I like to say Virabhadrasana was a spiritual warrior, because the great warrior that is able to cultivate inner peace has the ability to seize all wars around them. When we cultivate inner tranquility, inner peace, inner love, all wars cease around our immediate life from where we are today, where we stand right now. We're going to inhale, filling our hearts up with love, taking care of ourselves today, honoring ourselves, so then we have something to give to the world outside. We can't give what we don't have. So allowing ourselves to give ourselves love today first. Filling ourselves up with peace first, and then we can go out into the world and share that spiritual food with people around us. A great chef is the one that's eaten already and then shares their delicious dish with people and enjoys what they get from it. Let's inhale. We're going to exhale, turning towards the opposite side of our mat, opening our feet 2 to 3 feet apart, and we're going to exhale, turning to face again, the front of your mat, top of your mat. We're going to bend our front knee, and now we're on the opposite side. We're going to let our hips square off with the front of our mat here, and we're going to come into warrior one, Virabhadrasana one. If it feels better to have your arms out, you can keep them out, your hands, or you can keep your palms together. You would like to, it's good to explore, finding what feels good. You can interlace your fingers. I like to interlace mine. We're going to inhale here. We're going to exhale and gently come over. Again, if you have high blood pressure, you can come halfway down, or if you have a tight back, just letting yourself stretch out here, letting your pelvis go back while your shoulders are coming forward. You can come down if that feels good, finding what feels right. We're going to exhale and push off our front heel. We're digging it down into the earth. Pushing back into warrior two, letting yourself get a nice stable point. Your arms are coming out from your shoulders. We're going to inhale here. We're going to exhale. Inhale again. And we're going to exhale, bringing our front hand down by the side of our foot if we have that flexibility. If not, you can always come just halfway, finding what feels right, never pushing on your knee. Coming onto your thigh if that feels right, and your opposite arm. You could come up, you could bring your elbow down into your thigh if that feels good. Now we're going to look at our hand that's extending up towards the sky, towards the heavens, bringing that energy into our being today, uniting with our deepest self. We're going to exhale back into warrior two. We're going to take a nice inhale here. We're going to exhale, reversing. Inhale back into warrior two. Our hips are squared off with the side of our mat. Exhaling. And we're going to bend our front elbow, inhaling into this pose, coming into a side angle, a modified side angle pose, stretching our arms, coming up and over our ear, and it's shooting out forward. And we're just going to release here. If it feels good to look through your armpit, you can do that, or look down at the floor, depending on where your mobility is today. We're going to inhale back into warrior two. We're going to exhale, coming into reverse warrior. Inhaling back into warrior two. We're going to bring our palms together in a side namaste. It's a cultural Indian greeting. The spirit within me bows down to the spirit within you. And we're going to bring our elbow right inside our knee, the inside of our knee. I'm on my right knee. You might be on your left. We're going to look up if this feels good. Or you can look down if that feels better, finding what feels right for you. And we're going to inhale and come back into warrior two. Exhaling. Remember to, if you've never done yoga before, then just watching today, inhaling again and finding a good qualified teacher in the area. We're in San Gabriel, the beautiful San Gabriel Mountains, finding a teacher that you feel you can connect with. We have a lot of great teachers out here in all the area. We're going to inhale. And we're going to exhale. And we're going to inhale again. And we're going to bend. We're going to straighten our front leg. We're going to exhale, coming into side triangle, Trikonasana, stretching our arm up and over towards the sky, looking at that outstretched arm. If it feels better, you can come halfway. Just letting yourself get a nice stretch, finding what feels good for your body type. A lot of us are not aware of our bodies or what's going on internally, or we want to push ourselves beyond our limit, and that's not yoga. That's not healthy either. Finding your balance today, finding your harmony. We're going to exhale. We're going to bend our front knee, coming back into warrior two. We're going to inhale here, letting our shoulders release, our arms stretching out. We're going to push off our back foot, and we're going to come back into Shanti Mudra, Seal of Peace. Inhaling here, vitality, love, harmony. Exhaling, allowing it to go all throughout our body, using our mind to connect with our deepest being, is the ultimate form of yoga. Yoga meaning union with our super consciousness, our divine self, our ultimate being. It's so important to get in contact with that. When we live in a society where our life is going by very fast, urbanized, westernized world, we can end up trying to find instant gratification in everything. And as we see, it leads to physical problems, health problems, mental problems, spiritual problems. So allowing yourself to take time today to nurture your soul, nurture your mind and your body, taking time to love yourself, to slow down, to just feel the beauty of nature, that soft harmony that is nature. And we're going to inhale here. We're going to exhale. We're going to bring our arms by the side of our thighs. And we're going to gently again lift up on our tiptoes. And exhale, coming down. We're going to lift our toes up off the mat, just sitting on our heels for a moment. And let's gently go back and forth, going from our heels slowly to our tiptoe and gently finding a gradation so that we can slowly find where is our center point in our feet. We've lost that understanding, that proprioception, that awareness of our body, body awareness, body cognizance, coming in touch with what's going on in our internal being. And we can only do that by slowing down or closing our eyes. It's very important in yoga to feel our internal movements, taking this time to find out where are we today? Who are we? Who is our deepest self? And cultivating that. Confucius said, when we cultivate our essence, we become a trinity with heaven and earth. We become a trinity, like a channel, this beautiful, beautiful connection we develop. So allowing ourselves to take this time today to connect and then go out into our life from that place of centeredness, of harmony. We're going to inhale here, coming into a nice, stable Tadasana, mountain pose. Exhaling, spoiling ourselves, nourishing ourselves with the breath of life today. Inhaling, exhaling. We're going to gently open our feet a few inches apart. We're going to bring our arms up towards the sky if this feels good. We're going to bend our knees, coming into chair pose. Inhaling here. Exhaling. And we're going to slowly lower down, coming into a gentle squat, tucking your elbows in if this feels good. If not, we can just release. We're going to come into Shavasana. We're going to end our series today. Nice gentle yoga flow. We're going to lay down, and bringing ourselves down onto the floor, opening our feet a few inches apart. Letting the backs of our hands rest on the floor. You can use a pillow if you like. So now allowing yourself to lay down on the mat. Finding a nice comfortable position. If you see that your chin is coming too far up, you want to tuck a towel or a blanket underneath your head. Or you can use a pillow, finding what's comfortable for you. I'm going to do a walk guided meditation. Allow yourself to lay down in Shavasana, the corpse pose. And a deep relaxation pose, allowing yourself to release your body into the earth. And just gently closing your eyes, laying down, and allowing your body completely to release into the earth underneath you. And bring your mind's eye to the top of your head, feeling the top of your scalp. Allow it to gently release into the ground, allowing the top of your head to release. And bringing your mind's eye into the back of your neck and letting go. The top of your forehead, allowing yourself to release those wrinkles in between the forehead, the worry lines. Just letting go. Allowing yourself this inner harmony today. Releasing the space in between your eyebrows, that infinite point. Just gently letting go, bringing your attention down your cheeks and releasing the mouth and the jaw, creating nice space in between the back of your teeth, letting your mouth release, open, and gently letting your back of your shoulders release into your arms and your hands, letting go. And your chest, Bringing your mind's eye down your ribs, down your pelvis, letting it all release into the earth, letting gravity take you away. Down into your feet, letting your heels and your toes, the space between all the joints of your body, just release like the soft ripples of the ocean. Allow yourself to twinkle your toes now, twinkling your toes, letting yourself twinkle your toes, allowing yourself to twinkle your toes and your fingertips, letting yourself twinkle your fingertips, rotating your ankles and your wrists, and gently coming back into your body, bending your knees and your elbows, stretching, releasing yourself towards the two opposite ends. I want you to gently roll over onto one side of your body, finding a nice side position on your knee, on one knee, just rolling over into the fetal position, tucking your hands and your arms under your head, and gently letting your body realign by inhaling here and exhaling. And inhaling again. If you have high blood pressure or vertigo, you want to really take your time getting up, especially if you have vertigo, coming up very slowly. And to come up, I want you to push your palms into the floor and gently walk yourself back up. Come into seated position. You could bring your hands right by your heart again. You can even bring your hands right onto your heart, if that feels good, right onto your heart chakra. One hand on top of the other, if that feels better. And we're going to take a deep inhale here. Exhaling like a beautiful lotus flower. We blossom one petal at a time. And we're going to bring our hands together now, palms together, hearts together, our minds together. Positive thoughts, positive words, and positive actions lead to a positive life. The loving spirit within me bows down to the loving spirit within you. Namaste. Have a blessed day. Thank you for joining us today. If you want to end your series, you can always stay in the corpse pose, Shavasana, for only a minute. If you want to leave with more energy, if you want a deep relaxation, you can lay into it as long as you like. And I want to thank the community media of the Foothills for blessing us with this opportunity today, and to all the great yogis and yoginis out there, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to my teacher, Gil Elliott, and her teacher, Rupa Dora, to the Monrovia Yoga Co-op, a group of teachers, and a wonderful Apurva and her family for blessing us with her space and letting us grow as yogis. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a gorgeous week, beautiful weekend, and enjoy. Bye-bye.